my loves, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to be discussing lipsticks. Our favorite makeup product in the whole wide world, I'm sure for you and me, it's lipsticks, maybe highlighter, maybe eyeliner. I don't know. Why am I generalizing? It's my favorite makeup item. And it's so, so easy to make mistakes with lipsticks and make it look really, really crappy in spite of it being so easy to apply. So, in today's video, I'm going to be showing you 10 reasons why your lipstick could be looking bad on you. I know all of these 10 reasons because I've made these mistakes myself, so I'm not pointing fingers at anyone. I'm not judging anyone, guys. I'm just sharing the knowledge that I have learned through my mistakes. Like, I've been embarrassed enough and more. I don't want you to go through the same. So, let me start this video. Before that, guys, if this is the very first time you're seeing my face, hi, I'm Jovita. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, guys, my analytics say that 70% of you watching this video right now are not subscribed to my channel. Why? What are you waiting for? Click on that red subscribe button and let's get this party started. Lipstick problem number one could be a lipstick that is too sheer for you. This is especially a problem if you have really pigmented lips like myself. I have a different color top lip and a different color bottom lip, and that's very, very common for us brown girls. Nothing to be ashamed of or anything, but when you're applying a lipstick, you want that even look, right? This problem has a very, very simple solution. I know a lot of people say online to cover your lips with concealer first and then apply your lipstick. What I find is that when you apply concealer on your lips and then apply a sheer lipstick, the lipstick color mixes with your concealer color and you're not really getting the true color of the lipstick. It turns into some yellow orangey shade on me because my skin tone is yellow, my concealer would be yellow. So that's not a tip I would recommend. Instead, I'm gonna recommend getting a lip liner that closely matches the lipstick of your choice, the sheer lipstick that you're talking about. So apply this lip liner first as base and then apply your sheer lipstick and voila, problem solved. Lipstick problem number two is buying a lipstick that is way too light for your skin tone by mistake. And this is far too common for us brown girls. This is just far too common. It looks like we drank chocolate milk and we forgot to wipe our lips. It's not a cute look. The solution is very, very easy. Invest in a nice dark brown lip liner. So I have a couple of dark brown lip liners that I'm obsessed with. All you have to do is line your lips with a brown liner and then merge in your too light lipstick and you can use your light lipstick like this. Lipstick mistake number three is when your lipstick is way too bright. Like you intended the lipstick to be a bright look, but somehow it's just not merging into your skin tone, blending in with that whole look. It's just standing out, not looking good. The first thing you need to be doing as a solution is to apply concealer around your mouth and get rid of that hyperpigmentation or darkness around the mouth. A little bit of darkness around the mouth is very, very common for all of us brown girls. And when I say brown girls, guys, a lot of people misunderstand me. Brown doesn't mean just my skin tone. All Indian, Desi, Pakistani, Bangladeshi, Nepali, Sri Lankan skin tone is referred to as brown skin in general, okay? So all of us tend to have a little bit of darkness around the mouth, apply a little bit of concealer, and then apply a bright lipstick, and it's gonna look a-okay. I have detailed on this in my 11 makeup mistakes you might be making video. Just in case you haven't watched it, you can click it right here. Another thing that you can do is, once again, go back to your dark brown lip liner. If you wanna mute it down, line your lips with that brown lip liner and blend in that bright lipstick into your brown lip liner with your fingertips, and voila, you've got a muted down version of your bright lipstick. The lipstick is still gonna look bright if you leave the center of your lips bright, but of course it's gonna blend into your face without it looking too stark. Lipstick mistake number four is crooked edges. This is especially true when you're wearing bright red lipsticks or dark color lipsticks. Guys, that whole effect is ruined if your lipstick line is not clean and precise. For that, what I recommend is using a lipstick brush. So apply your lipstick using a lipstick brush. This helps to give you a nice, sharp, precise, clean line, and then fill in your lips with lipstick. Another thing you can do is, of course, go in with a lip liner first, or you can even go in with a concealer just in case you've made a mistake and you've got lipstick all over the edges. You can go in with a concealer with a tiny detailer brush and then clean that edges out for clean, perfect lips. Lipstick mistake number five, dry, peeling, flaky lips. This a lot of people completely ignore while wearing matte lipsticks because that it really shows your peeling, dry lips, and it's not a cute look. When you wear a nice matte lip, guys, you're trying to draw in the attention to your lips and you don't want your lips to be dried and peeling at that moment. You know what I'm saying? So my tips to overcome this is to, one, hydrate yourself from within, start drinking a lot more water, and every night without fail, apply a nice lip mask on your lips to start healing your lips. I completely recommend the Laneige lip mask. And just before you apply your lipstick, 1 hour before, apply a lip oil or your Vaseline or a nice thick lip mask and leave it on your lips for 1 hour. And then just before applying your lipstick, take a cloth and wipe all of that off. The cloth actually does a light exfoliation. It removes the dead skin and it removes all the dry, flaky skin from the top layer of your lips. And the lip balm also really hydrates your lips. So this will reveal soft, plump, hydrated lips for your lipstick day. Lipstick mistake number 6 is having way too many transfers. This is a problem if you want to hug your friends, if you want to kiss your friends, if you're out at a restaurant, you're leaving lipstick marks on all your utensils. It's not cute, right? A very easy solution to this is to layer your lipsticks. So apply one layer of your lipstick, take a tissue paper, place it on your lips and really blot down all of that excess moisture from the lips. Then take some loose powder on your makeup brush and pat it into your lips. This is gonna seal that lipstick on your lips, and you can remove the tissue paper and apply your lipstick once again and repeat this process 2 to 3 times, and this will make sure that your lipstick lasts all day and it also makes it transfer proof. Now obviously not completely transfer proof, it's not gonna like glue it on your lips, but it's gonna be a lot more transfer proof. It's not gonna be like smearing all over the place. Lipstick problem number 7. Now I know a lot of girls who are not confident enough to apply a lipstick straight from the bullet. They like a little tint, they don't want a full-on lipstick look. For that, again guys, you don't have to look for a sheer lipstick. You can work with a nice pigmented lipstick. All you have to do is apply it with your fingers. What? Yeah. So all you do is take a little bit of lipstick on your fingertip and start slowly dabbing it onto your lips, and this is gonna give you a beautiful lip stain look. It's gonna tint your lips, it's gonna stain your lips, and it's gonna last a very, very long time, and it's gonna look like your lips but rosier, or whatever color that you choose. Simple. Lipstick problem number 8 is when a lipstick is too dark. Now, I love dark lipsticks, guys, but sometimes it's just not what I'm looking for. A very, very easy solution is to take a lighter lipstick that you probably have and apply very little of that lipstick right to the center of your lips, and with your finger, slowly press that lipstick into your dark lipstick. You can do this how many ever times that you want. You can completely change the look of your dark lipstick. You can kind of make it medium, you can make it really, really light, you can almost make it nude this way. So play with your lipstick, mix and match. Simple tip, but sometimes we forget that these tips exist. Lipstick tip number 9. Your lipstick does not match your eyeshadow. So if you're wearing a pink eyeshadow and you are rocking a peach lipstick, it's clashing. It's just clashing. Now, I've spoken more about how you can choose your lipstick to match your eyeshadow and how it clashes and why it clashes and all of that in my makeup mistake video. So you can click on that right here. So we can move right along to our very last tip right now. Lipstick problem number 10, guys. Way too common. It's been happening from the birth of lipsticks, getting lipstick on your teeth. Now, I know, my Jovians, I'm sure you know how to tackle this, but just in case you're new to lipstick, I want to be here to help you. All you have to do is take your finger, pop it into your mouth, just like this, pull it out, and all of that excess lipstick will be circled around on your finger. You wipe that off and now you will not have lipstick on your teeth. And if you still have lipstick on your teeth, that's a really bad lipstick. Just get rid of it. So that's everything. Those are all of my lipstick tips for making your lipstick the prettiest ever possible. Now, your turn to comment. Let me know, what are those mistakes that you've been making, or were you not making any mistakes at all? Ooh, impressive. And if you enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a nice big old thumbs up. Click that like button. It really helps me out. And I shall see you in my next one. I love you. Mwah.